Hi, welcome to the Grower Pesticide Safety Course. This is Chapter 5, Pesticide Formulations. Chapter 5 starts on page 63 of the manual. There are 10 slides in this presentation. It will take us about 10 minutes to review it together. What will I learn? By the end of this session, you should be able to list the advantages and disadvantages of different formulations, or at least know where to look that up, define active ingredient, define inert ingredient, recognize common abbreviations for formulations, define adjuvant, tank mix pesticides properly and legally. So first, what is a formulation? A formulation is a mixture of chemicals and formulants. There are three main types: solids, liquids, and gases. A formulation contains active ingredients, one or more chemicals that control the pest. Inert ingredients, it'd be other chemicals that maintain the active ingredient. Examples, you could have a talc or an oil. Some inert ingredients may also be toxic and may affect the overall toxicity of the product. Common abbreviations for formulations. Sometimes you'll see a short form. In this case, we have control of 500 EC. EC is the short form for emulsifiable concentrate. You should find emulsifiable concentrate on the pesticide label front panel as well, but sometimes it will only be the short form. So knowing that will give you the clue, and you can read further into the label to make sure you know what is the abbreviation. Summary of formulation types. We have a chart in the manual, and this is listed first by solids, then liquids, then gases and organisms. And it will provide a brief description of what that formulation is, maybe some advantages and disadvantages for using that product from a safety perspective, and then a list of typical places where a formulation of that type would be used. Choosing a formulation. So there might be some questions you want to ask and think about. You've got a situation of a pest control situation that you want to manage this pest. So when is the pest most easily controlled, and will that make a difference on the formulation that you might purchase? Could the crop be injured at any of its growth stages, and are there formulations that would be maybe safer to the crop at a certain stage? What equipment will you need? So we have some herbicides that may be prone to drift, and that would cause herbicide damage on other crops. So you'd want to think about, is this formulation one that may drift? And then should I have to buy new nozzles, maybe coarse, very coarse or ultra coarse nozzles to reduce the drift when I use this type of formulation? Or is there a better formulation that I could use? What are the health risks when you use a certain formulation? So if you use something like water-soluble packaging, you may have less requirements for protective clothing equipment when you're mixing and loading that product, because the soluble packages themselves dissolve when placed in the spray tank. So there are health risks that you can consider when choosing your formulation. And what are the optimum weather conditions for the time of application? So we can have various times when temperatures might be too hot. It might be too hot to apply. So optimum temperature for a formulation might be between 10 and 20 degrees Celsius. And when the temperatures get to be 30 degrees Celsius, that may be not good for the use of that formulation on the crop. And you may end up with some crop injury if you're using it at a really hot temperature. So some of those things you can consider when you're in the mode of considering formulations for application to your crop. So pesticides can have the same trade name but be sold in different products, different formulations. So an example I have here. This is a herbicide, Devrol. It comes in 10G. probably 10% granule is what the 10G would represent. Deverol 2G, Deverol DF, DF being the short form usually used for dry flowable. So you have a choice of that product right there with three different formulations. Also, there could be different active ingredients involved with a different pesticide product formulation. So for example, here's the herbicide Callisto. And then we have Callisto with a GT following it. And this GT has an extra active ingredient. Glyphosate is in that product. So you have to be careful there. Just don't go out to buy Callisto without knowing exactly what you're buying. Look at the active ingredient, the guarantee on that pesticide label. Each formulation has its own registration number. So in this case, we have Control All 500 EC and Control All 480 SC. Two different formulations, same Control All as the trade name. So make sure that you know when you respond to an emergency that it's not just Control All, but you need the complete name, and more and better yet would be to have the registration number. If someone has an accident, give the correct registration number to the medical staff. Adjuvants. We should discuss adjuvants. What is an adjuvant? An adjuvant is any substance added to the product to make it more effective. It could be added to a spray tank or included in the formulation. So examples of adjuvants, wetting agents, spreaders, stickers, drift retardants, thickeners, anti-foaming agents, buffers. These are all extra things you add to a spray tank over and above the pesticide product. So they're all termed collectively as adjuvants. And when should you use an adjuvant? The label will tell you if you should use an adjuvant, and then which adjuvants to use and how much to use. Read the pesticide label. If you use an adjuvant without a label direction, the adjuvant may have no effect and may be an unnecessary expense. It may reduce how effective the product is against the pest or actually injure the crop. So be careful when you're adding an adjuvant, and certainly add them if the label tells you to. Tank mixes. We're going out in the field with one pass. We want to add the green product and the blue product together, and we're going to save some time. Now, are there label directions for the tank mix? No label directions for the tank mix, then the tank mix might not work. It could result in gelling or curdling in the tank. It could be more toxic to the crop. It could be more toxic to the applicator. It could reduce pest control, be an antagonistic reaction. It could leave unacceptable pesticide residues on the crop. So before mixing, make sure that you know they will work well together. If you mix products that do not have label directions on one of those product labels, you are responsible for what happens with that tank mix. And that's a little summary of the pesticide formulations chapter.